the touch and continuations of the Eid flavor still exist and will continue for a couple of the days. This year, our Honorable Home Minister was on pilgrimage to perform Holy Hajj. We could not celebrate it with him. So today, we are getting the opportunity to celebrate Eid's reception. You know, Eid al-Fitr after a holy month of Ramadan, and Eid al-Adha are the two great religious festivals of Muslims. Bangladesh is the abode of Muslims, Hindu, Christians, and Buddhists. They live in peace with close communal harmony. The celebration of religious events of a community is shared by the members of other religions in our country. Religion is the belief of an individual, but the celebration is for all, irrespective of religions. Distinguished guests, here around the room, we have a range of diverse people in terms of language, cultures, religions, and tradition. Let me quote from Kofi Annan, the former Secretary General of the United Nations, quote, "We may have different religions, different languages, and different complexions, but we all belong to one human race, and obviously, we all have similar goals. We look for peace and prosperity for a society. These are the common dreams that are certainly the sources of our strength," unquote. We do believe the remarks and work for common good for the people, for the society. Your Excellencies, ladies, are simple, hospitable, and peace-loving. A handful of criminals, terrorists, and travel mongers try to disrupt the peace and tranquility, support the terrorists and extremists. This is why the homegrown militants could be put under control by police with the help of the people. Repeatedly declared that not a single inch of our soil will be allowed to use by any terrorists or militants or insurgents of any neighboring country or any other country. After the tragic incident of Gulshan holy artisan in 2016, we started cracking down of the militants, and at the same time, we beefed up the security of the diplomats and other foreigners who are in Bangladesh with legal status. We put the highest priority to ensure the security of the foreigners. The officers of our Diplomatic Security Division of Dhaka Metropolitan Police, Special Branch, and local police regularly maintain coordination with you to provide services as per your demand and expectation. I do thank you all for your support and attachment with us. Excellencies, at present, the Rohingya refugees are the burning issue for Bangladesh. A huge number of Myanmar citizens, the members of the Rohingya ethnic group, took refuge in our country. Our Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has given them shelter, food, medicine, and security on humanitarian ground. But it is very difficult for Bangladesh to take the burden of the refugees for years. Myanmar government should take back their citizens soon. We are thankful to the diplomats who visited to the refugee camps and influx area in Cox's Bazar on 13 September. I think you have got the actual picture of the existing situation centering the Rohingya refugees. Ladies and gentlemen, there is a need for increased interaction, dialogue, and collaboration among us. I think this program has given opportunity to have interactions that will help us to get cooperation at the time of need and emergency. By creating opportunities for seamless connectivity, we can maximize gains and herald a new dawn in the field of security as well as development in the globe. We can all choose our power paths to our destination, but when we join our hands and walk in step, the path becomes easier, the journey quicker, and the destination closer. There is much to learn from each other, even more to do together. Finally, I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to Honorable Home Minister, State Minister for Foreign Affairs, diplomats, and dignitaries for your gracious presence. In the sequence of the program, after the discussion session, there will be a brief council program arranged in honor of the guests. I do invite you to enjoy the council program after the speeches of the chief guest and guest of honor. Council program will be followed by dinner of the eight reception. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. Thank you very much for your presence.
Today's evening. So truly, I'm grateful and thankful to all of you. Partnership, as you all know, is absolutely vital in achieving success in every single effort. And you see that Bangladesh government is always very positive and supportive to broadening our network, mutual collaboration, and getting national and international consensus in facing crucial issues. In today's world, since we are at a reception of the Inspector General of Police, so we must talk about some of the law and order situation across the globe and within the country as well. Today's world, terrorism is the biggest challenge. No country seems to be immune to this scourge. Terrorism undermines our efforts to maintain peace, security, retard our sustainable development, and demeans human rights. In Bangladesh, as you all know, Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina's government, we maintain a zero tolerance approach to terrorism and violent extremism. We have strengthened counter-terrorism legislation, an effective national strategy to combat terrorism, a robust intelligence network among concerned agencies, and constant vigil to disrupt terrorist networks and eventually degrade any potential violent extremist entities and tendencies at the same time. Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina often says, terrorists do not belong to any religion. Our government misinterpretation of Islam, our religion of peace. We have so far banned six local terrorist outfits, including the group that claimed to have killed some of the online activists in recent past. We're also making progress in stemming the flow of terrorist financing. The psychology of terrorism is very much people-centric, hence without the infiltration and understanding of people's psychology and emotion, a successful counter-terrorism measure cannot be adopted. Keeping this in mind, our Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has urged the guardians to keep a watch on their children so that they cannot be misguided. She has also asked to strengthen the existing anti-terrorism committees and community policing at district, upazila, and union levels. We are fortunate enough that we have already gained people's consensus, the major element to countering terrorism. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it is our pleasure to acknowledge that the prudent leadership of Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina also made our law enforcing agencies, including police, rapid action battalion, and so forth, capable, bold, and confident to encounter the recent surge of terrorism that the country has badly experienced. Now we are confident enough to dismantle this homegrown terrorist network in Bangladesh, their organizational and leadership framework at the same time. The Holy Artisan incident in 2016 was so surprising and unprecedented that many professionals, intellectuals, and policymakers.
I consider this an honor for me and also for my colleagues in the diplomatic corps to be invited to attend this special Eid reception, a program arranged by the highly respected IGP of Bangladesh. If I remember well, this is the first time that this type of program is arranged by the IGP of Bangladesh with the assistance of the Diplomatic Security Division. I take this opportunity as Dean of the Diplomatic Corps in Bangladesh to express on behalf of my colleagues our sentiments of deep gratitude to the Diplomatic Security Division for their help and assistance to all our diplomatic missions here in Dhaka. I appreciate your willingness and your readiness to protect all of us anywhere and anytime.
Excellencies and ladies and gentlemen, at the outset, we condemn the recent incident, terrorist attack in Holy Artisan, which took away valuable lives of our friendly countries. We pray for those departed souls and extend compensation to their bereaved families. We refrain our stance that our land is not to be used to the host terrorists. We must harden our effort to cut this means and take serious step to these ends so that terrorists do not escape prosecution and punishment. We have proved our capacity and subdue this means within a short span of time. In this continuing effort, minimizing terrorist threat, I would greatly acknowledge the meaningful and consolidated contribution from your end. The ambassadors, high commissions in Bangladesh, without having such collaboration and coordination, that alliance, we cannot make success in our effort to fight militant activities. Excellencies and distinguished guests, importance and recent response from our government to the fleeing Rohingya refugees. As per the statistics of UNHCR, 0.4 million Rohingya refugees have entered into our country so far. On a humanitarian ground, we have given them shelter, food, health care facilities, in spite of our huge internal commitment and limitation. The Rohingya export is increasingly day by day. It needs a long-term political solution as it might pose a multidimensional security risk to Bangladesh. Many of you have personally visited Bangladesh-Myanmar border and seen human miseries in your own eyes. We appreciate your role and expect more international pressure to Myanmar to resolve this international problems. This is a long-term journey to build and to evolve with this capability, but this is our task and it is a national and wherever we to make partnership and linkage with our neighbors and beyond the neighbors. I am thankful to Bangladesh police for their efforts in keeping our country safe and secure. Thank you for such reception. Joy Bangla, Joy Bangabandhu, may Bangladesh live long. Allah Hafiz.
Here we are going to start our culture story that we have wholeheartedly arranged for you.
Oh,
কুটি কুট 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 আসমানি দিয়া Yeah. Hindi.
Atmana sukha paayore,
anbe la.
জন্ম ভরে একদিন না আমি দেখলাম তারে আমার ঘরখানা কি জন্ম ধরে একদিন না একদিন না একদিন না আমি
performance. And once again, thank you, Honorable Inspector General Bangladesh Police, for hosting this event in honor of Ambassadors, Excellencies, High Commissioners, and Diplomats. Thank you so much. Dear guests, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let's have dinner. And thereby, this is the closing end. And to the mind-blowing performances of cultural group, now we will be experiencing cultural performances on the part of cultural group of Bangladesh Police. We'll be having dinner, and during that time, they'll be performing on the stage. Thank you so much, and have a very, very good night. Thank you once again.
Dunia kisi ke paas.